We are at Mykhailivka Square in Kyiv, the capital of Ukraine. 100 kilometers from here, 32 years ago, the fourth reactor of Chernobyl nuclear power plant exploded. As a result of the accident, an incredible amount of radioactive material was thrown into the atmosphere. Wind spread this radioactive material thousands of kilometers from the power plant. We will check the background level of radiation in Kyiv today. I will be using the FLIR identiFINDER R440 to measure the level of radiation. FLIR is known for its thermal cameras that can see in the dark. FLIR also manufactures chemical, biological, radiation and explosive detectors. An identiFINDER R440 is one of the radionuclide identification devices that FLIR manufactures. Let's check the level of radiation. 0.05 microsieverts per hour, is that a lot or it is normal?
Radiation given off from radioactive materials such as uranium, plutonium, cesium, etc. is ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation has enough energy to cause ionization in the medium it goes through. This is very dangerous for the human body. It is measured in sievert per hour. The natural radiation background in the world is between 0.1 and 0.2 microsievert per hour. 1 microsievert is 1 millionth of the sievert. What is the source for this radiation? Almost everything. Cosmic rays, mountains, concrete, water, food, you and I. A constant background above 1.2 microsievert per hour is dangerous to humans. With a single radiation dose of 1 sievert, a person may receive radiation sickness. A single dose of 8 sievert is fatal.
So, this is a normal level and not at all harmful. We will now go to Chernobyl nuclear power plant to measure the levels there. I'm at checkpoint Detatki, the main entrance to the Chernobyl exclusion zone. It is 30 kilometers from the reactor. The radiation level here is 0.05 microsieverts per hour. This is about the same as background radiation in Kyiv. I will be spending a few hours here. To measure the total amount of radiation I observed during the stay here, I will be using the FLIR identiFINDER R100. Behind me is the fourth reactor of the power plant that exploded 32 years ago. The level of radiation is around 1 microsievert per hour. This is about one-third of the level that you will receive if you are in an airplane 30,000 feet in the air.
The radiation levels increase as you go higher. This is because there is less atmosphere to act as a shield between you and cosmic rays. At 30,000 feet, the level can be between 3 and 6 microsievert per hour. Compared to 0.1 to 0.2 microsievert per hour on the ground. So, the radiation level at 30,000 feet are almost 30 to 60 times what the normal radiation level are on the ground. A chest X-ray gives you about 20 microsievert. This is same as about 4 to 6 hours flight. A chest CT scan gives about 7,000 microsievert.
Is it dangerous? Only if you live here or are exposed to it all the time. If you spend a few hours here, it is like an airplane ride from New York to London. We are now driving through the Red Forest Zone, which is located 1 kilometer from the Chernobyl nuclear power plant. 30 minutes after the explosion, the radiation level here reached 600,000 microsieverts per hour. Pine trees turned red-brown and died after receiving such a high dose. The forest has grown back today, but still absorbs radiation from the soil. The level of radiation is around 6 microsieverts per hour. I wonder what is the level of radiation is in the soil. Let's check. It is relatively high at 10 microsieverts per hour. FLIR identiFINDER R440 can also be used to identify the radioactive material giving out the radiation. Let's do that. The radionuclide identified is cesium-137.
Уважаемые товарищи, городской совет народных депутатов сообщает, что в связи с аварией на Чернобыльской атомной электростанции в городе Припяти складывается неблагоприятная радиационная обстановка. Партийными и советскими органами, воинскими частями принимаются необходимые меры. Однако, с целью обеспечения полной безопасности людей и в первую очередь детей, возникает необходимость провести временную эвакуацию жителей города. Для этого каждому жилому дому сегодня, 27 апреля, начиная с 14:00 часов, будут поданы автобусы. Просим соблюдать спокойствие при проведении временной эвакуации.
I'm in Pripyat at the children's playground. It is 3 kilometers from the power plant. On April 27, 1986, a day after the explosion, the entire population of the city, around 50,000 people, were evacuated. Now the city is like a museum. You can arrange for a tour of the city using a travel agency. The FLIR identiFINDER R440 can also be used to find the source of radiation. Let's see if we can find a strong source of radiation using the Easy Finder mode. The arrow is pointing towards the Ferris wheel. Wow! This is a very high level. The radiation level is 38 microsieverts per hour. You may have noticed that I had to come closer to the Ferris wheel to see the high dose. This is because the level of radiation varies inversely with the square of distance.
The intensity of radiation passing through any unit area is inversely proportional to the square of the distance from the radiation source. What this means is that the decrease and radiation intensity is proportional to the square of the distance between the source and the object receiving radiation. For example, if the dose rate is 72 microsievert per hour, 1 meter away from the source, it will be 18 microsievert per hour, 1/4 of the value, 2 meters from the source. It will be 8 microsievert per hour, 1/9 of the value, 3 meters away. This is important to know, because you can cut down your radiation dose by a lot by just moving a little away from the source.
Let's try to identify what is radionuclide is. Radionuclide identified as cesium-137 and cobalt-60.
Let's talk about half-life. Half-life is the time in which the radioactivity of a radionuclide falls to the half its original value. For example, half-life of iodine-131 is 8.1 days. The half-life of uranium-235 using fission bombs is 703.8 million years. One of the radionuclides that is detected at Chernobyl is cesium-137. The half-life of cesium-137 is about 30 years. This is important today, 32 years after the accident. The amount of radioactivity present because of the cesium-137 at Chernobyl is still a little less than half its original value.
I'm here at the site where the equipment for the cleanup operation of the reactor 4 was discarded. Here is the grappler which was used to pick up pieces of the reactor. Even after extensive decontamination, large amounts of radioactive materials was left on the grappler. Let's see and measure the level of radiation on the grappler. Wow, this is a very high dose rate. We are now moving away from the allowed route, and as you can see, the radiation levels have increased. The radiation here is irregular. It is therefore necessary to move strictly along the allowed routes. It is even more difficult to leave the exclusion zone than to get into it. At the checkpoint, radiological safety officers carefully examine each vehicle and all passengers to check the radiation dose they receive. In addition, they will check if you are smuggling something from the zone. You can be fined for this or even be imprisoned. Let's see the total dose I received during my stay at Chernobyl, recorded by the FLIR identiFINDER R100. 3.99 microsieverts, which is the same as 1 hour flight on 30,000 feet.